And you can go in prayer where you can't go anywhere else. Amen. And you're after somebody, put God on their trail. Amen. And hey, it was exciting to see you. And got saved in Boston. Come all the way down here. And if you could do me a favor, could you put your mask up a second for me? Yeah. Because I want to tell you something. I want to tell you what the big bad wolf should have told Little Red Riding Hood. Satisfied. His knowledge, my righteous servant, my many, we shall bear their name. repent and what?
Be baptized.
And what?
Amen.
Talking to now. Be baptized. People don't get saved without showing the word of God. And say,
amen.
And say you call on Jesus. And they won't know until you show them. Amen.
Amen.
It said, repent and be baptized. Who? For the remission of your sins. Notice it, for the remission of your sins. Now that four has a lot of different meanings. This four right here doesn't mean to make it happen. That means like, you ever seen the sign that said Joe Blow wanted for murder? They're trying to get him to go murder somebody? No, they didn't want it because he didn't murder somebody.
Yeah,
and it said, every one of you in the name of Jesus for the remission of your sins, because your sins have been washed away. Baptism, Bible baptism, it's for only people that have been. Then you can show them Acts 2:41. Then they that what? You got verse 2. They that what?
Glad.
Talk to me now. They that what?
Glad.
Oh, say, but I'm glad. Glad. Let me see you glad back there.
Amen.
Oh, say, but I'm glad. Jesus is coming like a silver run. Oh, say, but I'm glad. Hey, they that gladly receive his
word.
Nobody say on a good thought or good opinion or good work. They that gladly receive his
word.
Come to the word of God. Being born again, not a corruptible seed, been troubled by the word of God, living in the Bible forever. Glad to receive his word. Word what?
Baptized.
Baptized. See, you gladly receive his word, you get baptized. Yeah. And the same day, they're added to them about what?
3,000
souls. 3,000 people got. Talk about the numbers. Talk about statistics. Mm-hmm. 3,000 people got saved, and
3,000
people got
baptized.
And 3,000 people joined the church.
That's right.
Talk about a study like that, that'd be something, wouldn't it?
Amen.
3,000 say, everybody can. Hey, 3,000 people, how many are going to get baptized?
8,000.
How many join the church?
All 3,000,
man. That might do something for other folks around, amen?
Amen.
Now, that's the first thing God commands. And then you talk to somebody about baptism, what's the first thing they tell you about being baptized? Usually most people tell you what? I have. Okay, I have what? I already been baptized. Now, this is a baptism that you've never had. Talk to me now. This is a what? Talk to me. This is a what? Baptism you've never had. This is what the Bible calls believer's baptism. This is what the Bible calls what? Talk to me now. This is what the Bible calls what?
Believer's
baptism. Yeah. You want the people of Christ? Make it as you go back and go over there with them. Get them to church. Get them baptized. It's believer's baptism. It's not for people to just have them in their head, for people to have them in their heart. Okay? And then Acts 8:35-38, take a look at that right quick, right? You want to take these out, show them to people? He said, Acts 35:38, then Philip opened his mouth, and I tell him here's a guy, in this passage, here's a guy that had been to church. He'd been where? At church, and he was on his way home. But he didn't understand about going to heaven. So God sent somebody by to talk to him, just like he sent me by to talk to you. Are you listening? When you talk to folks, you want to see what we're doing and what they're doing as close to a Bible experience. What we're doing, just what they did in the Bible. That was just 2,000 years ago when that happened. Same thing. But God sent him to him. And notice he said he opened up his mouth. He opened his mouth and began where? And begin where? And begin where? Talk to me. At the same scripture. He said he took the Bible. It was the same scripture and preached in Jesus. He said he opened up the Bible, took out the Bible, and showed him about Jesus. Amen. And he said, open up your Bible. He didn't give him some kind of Sunday school program or some kind of literature or some kind of whatever that somebody wrote. He opened up the Bible. And showed it to him, Jesus.
Amen.
Jesus out of the Bible.
Amen.
See? And you're going in the right direction. You're following Jesus out of the Bible. And as they went on their way, they came to certain water. And he said, see, here's water. What doth hinder me? What will keep me from being baptized? He said, if what? thou believest with all thine heart thou mayest. It's not for everybody. It's just for people that got Jesus in their heart. You got Jesus in your heart, then you're qualified for believer's baptism. And he said, what? He said, if thou believest with all thine heart thou mayest. And he answered and said, what? I believe that Jesus is the Son of God. And they went down both in the water, both Philip and eunuch, and he baptized them. It's a baptism you never had. It's a believer's baptism. You got Jesus in your heart. See? And then in Acts 16, 29 to 33. Acts 16, 29 to 33. It's for believer's baptism. And then when you get baptized, Acts 16, 29 to 33, the Bible said, then he called for a light and sprang in, came trembling and fell down before Paul and Silas, and brought them out and said, sirs, what must I do to be saved? And they said, what? Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved and thy house. All you got to do is what? Believe. Be a believer. See? And they spake unto him the word of the Lord, and all that were in the house. And he took them the same hour of the night, what? And washed their stripes, and what? Was baptized in all his straight way. Now the Bible said that the same day men received his word were baptized. Same day they had in him. He got baptized right here. Same day, same hour. God, he wants you to be baptized same hour, right away. You want to have a 24-hour soul winning campaign, man. Same hour, same day. I've had a lot of folks change their plans, come in and get baptized because you showed them what the Bible says, see? And then verse number 48, I'm telling them, hey, if you got Jesus in your heart, and I can't recommend you do this. This is not a recommendation. Acts 10, 48. Get Acts 10, 48. Take a look at that. I can't recommend you do this because it's not a recommendation. It's a Bible command. Acts 10, 48 said, and he what? And he what? He commanded them what? Be baptized in the name of the Lord. You're saved? Get in the water. You're saved? Get in the water. You're saved? Get in the water. See? He commanded to be baptized. It's a Bible command for everybody that's saved. Now, that's what Jesus commanded. Great Commission, Matthew 28, 19 and 20. And I always start in Matthew 18. In Matthew 18, it said, Jesus said, all power is given unto me. Jesus said, now that word power, there's two different words in the Bible. Power, one of them, when we get the word dynamite, that's the power on the inside, you know? Like Hulk Hogan or somebody's weightlifter or something like that. That power. There's another power, is power, the word authority. The power comes to authority. And that's the word here. All power, all authority is given to me. And where that comes in, how does that help me out? I'll tell you how it helps you. You know, here's a tractor trailer truck. I need to take a little lady, put a beautiful blue uniform on her, give her a whistle, put her out there and blow that whistle and stick her hand out. What's going to happen? You're going to stop that truck. He's got good sense.
I just know a little gal ain't going to stop that truck. She got the power, authority.
Jesus said, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. Go you there. That's where you got power in prayer. That's where you got power. Shot and wiped out because they got nobody behind them. But you got God Almighty backing you. And he said, all power is given to me. Go ye therefore and teach all nations. And what? 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 Talk to me now. What? What'd he say? Baptizing them. It's a Bible command. Jesus commanded it. I'm just making baptize in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Observe all things whatsoever commanded you. See? Now tell them and explain to them. You know, a lot of people are not familiar with explaining what Bible baptism is. Romans 6:4 says, Therefore, we're buried with him by baptism into death, that like, that's your key word here, that like, it's a picture, that like as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, even so we should also walk in newness of life. And I'll explain this to you. Come to church. In Bible baptism, come to church, Bible baptism, the preacher take you, put you under water, and bring you back up. By that, you're saying, look, everybody, died right now, even though they put my body under the ground, my parents who were up. The Lord's getting further away every day. Amen. I got a life of my parents who are sinners just like me, and that life I got from them is taking me all the way to a cemetery. I got a new life from Jesus. Amen. Taking me all the way to heaven. Amen. And identified with Jesus in the death, burial, and resurrection. Amen. You know, if I ever joined a baseball team, they try to give me a sailor uniform, I say, wait a minute. I thought I'd join the Army. Well, I joined the Navy, they've got to give me an Army uniform. A lot of people, you talk about baptism, oh, wait a minute, because they hadn't really been saved. You got saved by the Spirit of God. You want to follow in believers' baptism. Yeah. How would people know they need to be saved if somebody didn't tell them, amen? Yeah. How are you going to know they need to be baptized? Somebody didn't talk to them about it. And then give you another verse here, Hebrews 12. 6 and 7. Hebrews 12, 6 and 7. Now, once you receive Christ as Savior, you become a child of God. Talk to me now. You receive Christ as Savior, you become a child of God. And you come under His commands. You know, when I joined, the Army had a lot of commands. They didn't mean anything after I joined. When I joined, I came under the Army's commands. You know, woe be unto me if I didn't carry them out. You know, I said, now the Bible said here, 12, Hebrews 12, 6 and 7, for whom the Lord loveth, he what? Chasteneth, and he scourgeth every son whom he receiveth. If you endure chastening, God dealeth with you as with sons. For what son is he whom the Father chasteneth not? See, a lot of people got the idea you get saved. That means you want to get saved? Child of God. See? I got five boys, and I was over in South Carolina preaching. Called up some of my cousins. Hadn't seen him for years, you know, and they hadn't seen me for a long time. Hadn't seen any of our kids. But you know what? When they got out there to the church, they walked in there, saw these guys, and they said, you're an Allen, aren't you? They didn't work at it. It just happened because they're born in the family, amen? When you get born in the family of God, it's going to show up. Yeah. You're going to start looking like your Heavenly Father. Yeah. You're going to start talking more like Him, walking more like Him, thinking more like Him, acting more like Him, but you got to be born in the family, amen? And when you receive Him, and then we're still going to sin, we're going to do wrong because we're still in a sinful flesh, but we got a new life in Christ. And so, as a parent, everything you tell your kid to do, you tell them because it's going to help them or hurt them. It's going to help them, see? And it bothers you when your kids disobey because it's not going to help them. It's going to what? Hurt them, see? And so God, our Father's concerned about that. And everything He tells us to do, it's for our good. It's for the very best, see? And the first thing God commands you after you're saved is to be the first thing God commands to be saved after saved, what? Be baptized. Baptism doesn't save anybody, doesn't help save anybody. But baptism is important because it's the first commandment God gives you after you're saved. The Bible says, whom the Lord loveth, He chasteneth. If you have a son that doesn't, a child doesn't obey you, what are you going to do? You're going to discipline. Now, if you really, talk to me now. If you really receive Christ as Savior, you didn't just pray something in a prayer. You are a child of God. And the first thing God commands you is to be what? Baptized. And if you don't come and get baptized, you're being what? Disobedient. When you get when you're disobedient, that means you're going to come under the discipline of your Heavenly Father. First get saved. Now, get saved, get baptized. And those are the command. And verse 4, John 14, 15. John 14, 15. He said, if you love me, what? Keep my commandments. It shows that you love me. Now, here. And now, it's important. If you don't get, if they're saved, or really saved, and now, here's this too. See, somebody's not saved, they got don't have much push for being baptized. But if you're saved, who's living on the inside? Yeah, Jesus. The Holy Spirit is on the inside, and the Holy Spirit's on the inside telling you, that's right, you better do it. And if you don't get you get saved, you don't get baptized, you're being disobedient, and you bring yourself under the discipline of God. And I tell them, hey, look, if you don't come and get baptized, don't be surprised when you start having problems and troubles, and you want them to stop. Come get baptized. How are they going to know that if you don't do it? And another important thing, too, is that when you get saved, first commandment after you get saved is to get what? Baptized, see? Now, here's what we got. First command that God gives you, why wait for baptism? And you got a lot of people out unbaptized converts get saved, and they're retarded Christians. They live all their life, never progress, never get anything done, because they don't obey that first command, get baptized. It keeps you from growing in the Lord, and it brings you under discipline. And you go out and win the soul of Christ. Jesus commanded, he did not only said, go and all and preach the gospel to every creature, but he said, get your converts baptized, and get them in church. I got a few other things here. Remember, some other time we cover, come back down here again, about a plan to get people in church. I get people saved because I got a plan of salvation. Get people baptized because I got a plan of baptism. Get people in church because you got a plan to join the church. You know? He said, Jesus said, upon this rock will I build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Everybody, the Lord added the church daily, so you should be saved. If you're saved, get baptized. For the pastor of the local New Testament church. Thank God for God's people. You know, the great thing is you got the people of God led by the man of God doing the work of God and the power of God according to the word of God and the glory of God. And hey, remember in school had all the game, had the cheerleaders go fight, win, go fight, win, go fight, win, go fight, win, go fight, win. Go fight, win. Hey, the Church of the Lord Jesus Christ, let's get with it. Go. Because God commands us to go. Fight. Because we're fighting a good fight of faith. We're more than conquerors in him that loved us. And win. We've already won. This is victory overcome this world, even our faith. And let's pray. Our faith is blessed. Now we're going to the power of the Holy Spirit. Knowing how we're backed by the Word of God. Lord, help us explain salvation to folks. Help us explain baptism. Help us explain church membership. Lord, help us. By you, to get folks to do what you want, to do what you commanded, to get people in the ministry that God called pastors so they can learn to do the work of the ministry, go out and get more people saved, baptized, and get them in the Bible. Lord, bless us and help us. Jesus.
Give him a hand, Brother Lewis Allen. Give him a hand. What a challenge. A blessing. What a conference we had this week. And a wonderful time. Went out soul on Thursday night. The banquet last night. And can you imagine this? We're carrying it on this morning and closing it out. Isn't that wonderful with Brother Lewis Allen? Isn't that wonderful? And we praise the Lord. Thank you so much for that great exhortation. And he baptizes. He baptizes. We've been here to First Baptist Church in Hammond. What a blessing they've been to us. When Joy got married to Laurent, of course, Joy graduated from Bible college there. They were there, always encouraging. This family always been encouraged, encouragement during that time we visited down there. You're always an encouragement to me. And in the old Jack Hiles Auditorium, some of you that haven't seen it, you got to go way up. I mean, there's flights of stairs way up, way up. I want you to picture up my office up there, about three times more flights up there. You had to walk up there. And it was narrow. It was narrow. It was narrow. They got several baptistry rooms, big rooms where people change up there. Big room. They baptized thousands, 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 thousands of people. Thousands. I mean, just getting old people going up there. And I thought about all those walks. Then I thought about the older men that had to go up there and go up there and walk up there. There was no elevator. And I want you to think about my office up there, about three times higher. I didn't know it. It's winding. And it's narrow. And so that means thousands of these old people and middle-aged people, of course, and children, teenagers, will go up there. After the service, they come flooding down and pointing them the way, pointing them the way. He helps Brother Gomez, I believe. Is that correct? Right now, he, in his age, he baptizes and helps the assistant pastors. Baptizing them. What'd you say, brother? You use the same one? That's what you use? You go up and let's give him a hand. Let's cheer him on. I didn't know it. Even with his bad knee. Excuse me? Yeah, with the COVID. When it started? After things were shut down, when they started baptizing. He was in the first. They were just preaching in jail. He got saved, he got baptized. You got one of the first ones got baptized after the COVID, after they shut down. Let's give God the praise, friends. Gospel works everywhere. I told you, special touch of God upon him and his boys, and Jay and John. You guys are a blessing to us. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for Brother Lewis Allen. We live in history, in the breaking, our Bible conference, how you have touched our hearts this week. And this is the thing where it all began last Sunday morning. Brother Tim kicked it off. And Brother Lewis Allen, after our conference, closing it out. Pray you bless him. Bless his boys. Thank you for our banquet last night. Thank you for all the food. Thank you for all the fellowship. Thank you for the gifts. Thank you for being so good to us. Now help us share some things before we go out, and that we be organized for tomorrow. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. And of course, we have that wonderful bus that we're striving to purchase. We're able to use it until we purchase it. Beautiful bus. And Sandy, Sister Sandy, thank the Lord for it. They're working for Lynch Bus Lines. Will be planning on